Our lesson today, how to add and subtract two fraction or two mixed number or mixed number and a fraction. You studied that before, am I right?
Yes. Yes.
So I'll check if you understand or not. If we have two fraction, 3/7 plus 1/7.
4/7.
It doesn't work to answer without permission. Okay. So, if we have same denominator, so we can write directly, right? Then we can add the numerator directly. So 3 + 1 = 4, so 4/7. So if we have same denominator, we can add the numerator together to find the answer. What about if we have 3/7 plus 4/5? Okay. How to add them? Ranim?
Change the denominator to
35
because this is the common number between
7
and 5.
Yes. We
multiply by.
How to get same denominator?
7 times 5 and 5 times 7,
and then we'll take. Yes, you can. To get same denominator, you can multiply 7 by 5 and multiply as well 3 by 5. Okay. Then same, multiply 5 by 7, 4 as well by 7. Now you have 3 times 5, 15. 15 out of 35 plus 28 out of 35.
And then
we add 28 + 15 = 43 out of 35. Can you simplify more? Can you divide by any number? We cannot simplify, but if we need to write as a mixed number, we can do that. Because if the numerator greater than the denominator, this improper fraction. Improper fraction, if it mentioned to convert to mixed number, you can convert to mixed number. How many 35 and 43?
One.
And what about the remainder?
8/64.
Yes, we have remainder 8, so 1 and 8/35. This is how to add to fraction. Same if when we subtract 2/3 - 1/4. Yes, Lama? Do you have same denominator?
No.
How can you change to have the same denominator?
3 times 4.
Yes, multiply 3 times 4. First, yes.
4 times 3.
Then, if you multiply denominator by four, you have to multiply numerator as well by 4. Because we need equivalent fraction to 2/3, but with different denominator. So when you multiply the denominator by 4, you have to multiply the numerator by 4. Okay? Multiply the denominator for the second fraction by 3, so you multiply the numerator by 3. Now, can you complete? Go on. 8/12. -3/12 - 5/12. Understood?
Yes.
If we have mixed number, for example, 2 and 1/4, -1 and 1/5. How to subtract? If you have mixed number, Mayar. Wait. Before same numerator, it's better, but you can solve without. It's better to convert the mixed number to fraction. Can you convert the mixed number to fraction?
Yes.
Yes, how to convert the mixed number to fraction?
2 times 4.
Yes, 2 times 4.
8 + 1? 9.
So the numerator 9, 9/4? 4. Same. 1 times 5? 5 + 1?
6.
So 6/5. Now you have two fractions. You can subtract as before. It's okay.
5 and 9 times 5.
Yes.
And
multiply by 5. Multiply by 5. multiply by 4. Okay. Now, 9 times 5.
45.
Okay. Over. Minus. 6 times 4, 24. 24 over 20. Now subtract.
Now 45 minus 24.
Equals 21 over 20. If you need to convert to mixed number, if it's required to do that, 21 over 20. How many 20 in 21?
1.
And the remainder?
1 over 20.
So 1 and 1 over 20. 1 and 1 over 20. Okay? And now it's time to practice. So for number 1, solve D and H. D, Nurhan?
2 times 5 plus
18, plus 18. Okay. So 2 times 5, 10, 10 plus 3, 13 over 5.
Plus
9 over 10. Okay. Guys, listen. You can multiply 5 by 10 and 10 by 5, but you have large numbers now. But it's better to have the same denominator.
Okay, can I multiply 5 by 2 and 10 by 1?
Okay. If you can change the small number to the bigger one, you can change 5 to 10. Am I right? You can multiply 5
by 2
to get 10. So this is easier. Easier than to multiply 5 by 10 and 10 by 5. So if the greater denominator is divisible by the smaller one, so you don't need to multiply each denominator by the next number. So multiply 5 by 2 directly. So if you multiply 5 by 2 and multiply 13 as well by 2, now you have same denominator. 26 over 10?
Yes.
Plus 9 over 10?
Equals
35 over 10.
Divided 5
equals 10. Yes. Can we simplify?
Yes. Divided 5
equals 10. Yes, we can divide by 5, divide by 5.
Equals 7 over
2. So 7 over 2. Yes, 7 over 2, you can convert to mixed number. 7 is not divisible by 2, but 6 divisible by 2. 6 divided by 2 equals 3. So 3 and 1 over 2 is 3 and a half.
Yeah.
As a mixed number.
Sorry?
If you, wait. If you multiply by 5 and multiply by 10, we have 13 over 5 plus 9 over 10, okay? You can multiply 5 by 10 and multiply 13 as well by 10. Multiply 10 by 5, multiply 9 by 5. Now you have 130 divide 50 plus 45 over 50. If you add, you get 195 over 50.
75.
Sorry. Now you can divide by 5, or you can divide by 25. You get 7 over 2. Then, same, 3 and 1 over 2. So you can simplify. You need to simplify more. Okay? But this is easier. The first way is easier.
Sir, I finished.
Leanne?
Two
times 9, 18. 18 plus 5, so 23 over 9.
Plus
1
over 4.
Plus 1 over 4.
Equals to 92 over
36
plus
9
over
36. Wait, I need the working. Multiply 9 by 4.
Yes.
Multiply 9 by 4, because we cannot convert 4 to 9. So multiply 9 by 4 and 4 by 9. And 4 by 9, 1 by 9. So 23 times 4, 23 times 4, 92 over 9 plus 9 over 36, sorry, plus 9 over 36
equals
101 over 36. Can you write as a mixed number? You can use your calculator to write as a mixed number, but without calculator you can do also. 101, how many 36 in 101? Maybe you can say that 2 times 6, 12, to carry up 1. 2 times 3, 6 plus 1, 7, so 72. If we subtract
11.
So sorry? 1 minus 1 doesn't work? Wait. We don't need to use calculator at all in this lesson. So if 101 contains 236, 2 multiplied by 36, 72. Now we need to subtract 1 minus 2, so we need 11. 11 minus 2, 9. And 9 minus 7 equal 2, so 29. So equals 2 and 29 over 36. This is the answer as a mixed number. Okay? Okay. 2 times 9, 18. 18 plus 5, 23. So convert the mixed number to improper fraction first. Then now have the same denominator for both. So try to not use the calculator in this lesson. Try to solve without calculator. Okay. Number 2, solve D and H. Number 2, solve D and H. Yes, D and H. Same. Yes, Talin?
Sir, first we have to make the mixed number into an improper fraction.
Yes.
So 10 multiplied by 1 equals 10 plus 7 equals 17 over 10.
1 minute. So 17 over 10 for the first fraction. And for the second fraction?
It would be 5 over 4.
Okay. Next.
So you
have, look for the denominator, you have 10 and 4.
I can make it 20.
Yes.
Multiply 2.
Yes, good job. So 20 divisible by 10 and 4. So you can make the common denominator. The lowest common denominator for both will be 20. So multiply 10 by 2 and multiply 17 by 2. Multiply 4 by 5 and multiply 5 as well by 5. Now? 34 over 20.
Minus
25 over 20. Equals?
9 over 20.
9 over. Good job, Terry. Good job. Okay, go ahead.
3 over 10 we have to make to improper fraction. So our 3 times 10 is 30, plus 3 is 33. And our.
So now, 33
over 10.
Over 10, yes?
Minus 1 over 2.
Okay.
Now, sir, I had a question here. Is it okay if I multiply the 10 and 33 over 10 by 1 and multiply the 1 over 2 by 5.
Okay, same. Yes, you can do that. Because look for the denominator, we have 10 and 2. We need same denominator. So we can convert, we can convert 2 to 10 by multiplying by 5. So multiply this fraction by 5. Numerator and denominator multiply by 5. Okay, go ahead.
Okay, then I will multiply them both by 5. It will be 33
over 10 minus 5 over 10. It will be
27 over 10, and the fraction of it will be
27
over 10.
27 over 10? 28 over 10. Okay? 33 minus 5, 28. So 28 over 10. Can you convert to mixed number?
2 and 8 over 10.
Yes. 2 tens and 8, so 2 and 8 over 10. Yes. 8 over 10, we can simplify, divide by 2, divide by 2.
14 over 5.
2 and 4 over 5. 2 and 4 over 5 as a mixed number in the simplest form. 4a, calculate the perimeter of each rectangle. 4a, so solve 4a. We have rectangle. The length 7 and 1 over 3. The width 4 and a half. I need the perimeter for the rectangle. Remember the perimeter? two length plus two widths. Two lengths plus two widths. At all sides. So if this 4.5, so the opposite one 4.5. If this side 7 and 1/3, so this 7 and 1/3. If I need the perimeter, at all. For number 4a, if we need to add sides, we can start with 4.5 plus 4.5. Okay, 4.5 plus 4.5 equal what?
8 and 2/2.
So this means 9. Okay, so 4.5 plus 4.5 equal 9. Same, 7 and 1/3 plus 7 and 1/3. So we can add without convert the mixed number to fraction. We can add without convert the mixed number to fraction because we have same denominator. So 7 plus 7, 14. 1/3 plus 1/3 equal 2/3. Okay? 2/3. Now we need to add 9 plus 14 and 2/3 to find the perimeter. So 9 plus 14 and 2/3. 9 plus 14 equal what? 9 plus 14. 23. So 23 and 2/3. So this is the answer. As a mixed number, so you don't need to convert the mixed number to fraction. Multiply by what? By 2. Because look, you can multiply 4.5 by 2 or add 4.5 plus 4.5. You can multiply 7 and 1/3 by 2 or 7 and 1/3 plus 7 and 1/3. Okay. So because we need to add and subtract only on this lesson. So I didn't multiply, okay? So add 7 plus length plus length and width plus width, then add together to find the perimeter. Now solve B, find the perimeter for this rectangle. 9 and 3/4 plus 9 and 3/4 equal 18 and 6/4, but 6/4 can be written 3/2. If you divide by 2, divide by 2. 3/2 equal 1.5. So 1 plus 18 equal 19. So 19.5. So 9 and 3/4 plus 9 and 3/4 in simplest form 19 and 1/2. 5 and 1/6 plus 5 and 1/6 equal 10 and 2/6. We can simplify this fraction. Divide by 2, divide by 2. So 10 and 1/3. Now we need to add them. 19.5 plus 10 and 1/3. Convert to same to have the same denominator. Multiply by 3, multiply by 3, 2 times, multiply by 2. So this will be 19 and 3/6 plus 10 and 2/6 equals 29 and 5/6. Now solve 5a by your own. To find the missing, subtract. So 3 and 1/4 minus 1 and 1/2. So convert to proper fraction. So 3 times 4, 12, plus 1, 13/4, minus 3/2, times 2, times 2. So 13/4, minus 6/4. So 7/4, as a fraction, as a mixed number, 1 and 3/4. So 7/4, or 1 and 3/4 is the same.